The Wally Show podcast is our daily radio show heard live through the WayFM app each morning and hosted by Wally, Gavin, and me, Betty Rock. For more fun, be sure to connect with us at wayfm.com/Wally.
The Wally Show podcast is brought to you by Colorado Christian University Online, where you can earn a degree online just like Betty Rock. You can learn more at ccu.edu/Wally.
Uplifting WayFM.
Here's what's going on today.
Back in the 1950s, if a product contained a warning label, it probably was a medication or a pesticide of some kind. It made sense right. why it would have a warning label. Anything else was left up to you to use some common sense. But
oh, there's the problem.
But these days, common sense isn't as prevalent. And you can see that in the amount of warning labels on everything.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. I saw a warning label on a pressure washer that said, don't drink from this. I mean, a pressure washer will open your skin if you hit it close enough. Mm. And I asked the guy, I'm like, is that really necessary? He goes, dude, somebody last week tried to drink from it. Goodness. I'm like, are you kidding me?
Yeah. And it makes sense why manufacturing companies are warning us on everything. We've become so lawsuit happy. So no company wants to be sued, you know, but it looks like all of those labels are actually backfiring. So we've become so accustomed to seeing warning labels on everything that we actually don't pay attention to them anymore. We've become desensitized.
I totally get this. It's kind of like anything when you cry wolf kind of thing, mm-hmm. or when you make an issue out of everything, the things that are real issues no longer are issues.
Yeah, you can go to the store and everything is like, this is dangerous, this is dangerous. Well, then what do you do?
I get where you get complacent and you ignore the one or two that really is.
Mm-hmm. And so we may see a redesign on some products to make them safer, like requiring someone to pull a lever and push a button to start a lawnmower instead of just having to turn a key. So yeah, they're trying to protect us from ourselves.
Right. Yeah, I know. And that's just because we have people that do ridiculous
things. And I think it's getting worse because of people wanting to get attention on social media. So they'll do dumb things just to get attention. And then people end up in hospitals.
And then we all get a warning label. Yeah. My lawnmower, to mow backwards, like hit it in reverse and mow backwards, you have to turn the key one click and push a button. And so that way you know you're in that mode and to be mindful
is
to not
helpful?
Run over anybody. I guess. I don't look back. I don't know if I've done anything or not.
I think the next step is putting warning labels on people.
Like yeah, you that might need would a be a good idea. Label. Yeah, that would probably be a better idea. Uplifting Way FM. This is The Wally Show. We're going to do a little one-word weekend. You'd give us one word that describes your weekend, and we are going to try to guess what happened. My one word is shocking. Shocking is my one word. Gavin, let's start with you.
Oh, boy. Okay. I wanted to go down the route of the, like, literal shock value.
Right.
I don't think you got electrocuted.
Right.
Because that would be bad.
I'm still here.
Yeah. I think that...
My hair's not curly.
No, I think that... You got a haircut. It looks shorter.
I did. Thank you.
I think
you didn't say it looked good. You said it looked shorter. Okay. And I'm like, oh, thank you. Thank you so much.
So ready for compliments.
Shorter.
I think that you were wearing, like, a fuzzy sweater or something and had probably the biggest electric shock when you, like, touched your wife and it, like, woke her up. Like, you did it... Like great in the guess. Morning, and it woke her up, and she was bad.
That's a great guess because I get, like, I have static electricity in my veins. I can shock things. I can turn off monitors here at the studio in the winter. It's bad.
It's a power.
Not true. Gavin, or Betty Rock. I was right at you and said Gavin.
You should be insulted by that.
I'm going to say that Marty shocked you, your wife.
Yeah.
She shocked you because she is a very picky eater, and once she gets a hold of something that she's loved for years, she gets a hold of something like bad, and now she hates that place.
It's gone
like
forever.
Now it's dead to her.
Absolutely.
But I think she shocked you by saying, hey, we should go eat at so-and-so, and you were shocked because... It's been dead to her.
That would be such a good day.
She is the queen of cancel culture.
Absolutely, she is. Cancel food culture? Yeah. And oh, I would live for that day when she would bring it back. But no, she did not. Gavin, your first instinct was right about literal shocking.
Oh, good.
Oh, no.
I shocked myself, literally. I was putting in a light switch in our house.
Oh, yeah.
And I turned off the power to what I thought was the switch bank, but it was actually just to the section of the house.
Oh.
And as I stuck my hand in to replace something, I made contact with the other one, and I shocked the snot out of myself.
You feel it in your toes?
Oh, yeah. And then the wire got stuck on there and was like...
No, it was not.
Yeah, it was. Yeah. So it was...
Wally.
Yeah, it was bad. My heart skipped a beat. And but then I'm like, hey, honey, I don't know if I have to take my heart medicine anymore.
Oh, my gosh. That's terrible.
Yeah, I got myself really good. But then it's like, you know, then I go through all this stuff with this switch, you know, and then I find out it was because I was trying to do a smart switch. And then I find out because of the way my house is situated, it's the wrong switch. So I'm like, dadgummit. So I shocked myself for no reason. And then when I tell my wife, I said, it's the wrong switch. I've got to order a different one, but it'll be fine. She goes, oh, I don't really want them anymore. I'm like,
Cancel culture once again.
Yeah, I almost killed myself for no reason, apparently. Shocking is right.
My one word is wimpy.
Oh, let me see your arms. Okay, I think you went to the gym, like, for the first time, and you went with your friend, like, it's going to be fun, we're going to lift weights, we're going to get jacked, and no, we're going to tone things up, and you went there, and you found out that you have wimpy arms and could not lift the weights.
Okay, that's a little rude.
Yeah.
I already know that I'm a little wimpy in that area, but no, that is not it.
No, we always kid around, like, Betty's like, yeah, you got guns. I got the guns. She's like, I got BB guns. All right, Gavin.
I think that, I know you hung out with your parents this weekend. Mm-hmm. I think you guys went to a restaurant, and you didn't know this, but apparently your dad's wimpy when it comes to spice. He's the toughest man on earth otherwise, but apparently he's wimpy when it comes
to... Ooh, you better watch your words.
I know.
Yeah. I've beat you up.
I've never met the guy before.
Yeah.
I want to keep it that way now.
Oh, absolutely. You don't want to meet him. You want to see him coming, honestly.
You know what?
What?
You are almost right,
No!
Gavin.
How is that possible?
But it's not my dad.
I figured.
It's me.
Oh. Hey.
So I go to this hot chicken place after church on Sunday with a bunch of friends. And some of the guys, they got like... extra hot, like dragon spit.
No.
They want it hot. And the lady looked at me and I said, listen, I want the wimpiest thing you have. I'm a wimp and I want my chicken wimpy.
Enjoy your food.
Yes. And so I'm so glad that I ordered wimpy because they ended up, the guys that had like the dragon spit, they were crying.
Yeah, I was like,
you can't even enjoy that.
It's not enjoyable when you're eating something that your nose is running into. You know?
Yes.
I'm serious. Like it's so true. It's not enjoyable.
It's not.
Take it down a notch. What are you trying to prove?
Right.
You know?
It leads to tummy issues.
Yes.
You don't want
absolutely get
bad IBS from that.
No, you do not. You're right. And tummy issues are always a problem. All right, so what is yours? Give us that one word and we'll try to guess your weekend. 855-33-WAY-FM. We got time for a couple more. 855-33-WAY-FM. What do you got?
100K.
100K. I'm hoping that this is you winning a small portion of a lottery.
Oh,
and you
Crystal.
Got 100K out of this, and you're like, what just happened? I cannot wait to pay half of this to the government.
Well, I did say what just happened, but I didn't win any money.
Oh, that's a bummer. Okay.
Okay, 100K. I think that, what is the thing where they like, with a diamond, don't they say like carrot? Like
Yeah,
they
carrots.
Call it, like,
yeah.
But they call
Those
it,
are C's.
Oh, dang it. See, I'm a single. I don't know. Okay, I think that you had, you're trying to get more fiber, more bran into your system. And so you bought yourself a box of Kellogg's Special K. Cereal. And you ate like 100 bowls and it really backfired, if you know what I'm saying.
Or did it?
that's not it.
All right. Well, what is your 100K, Crystal?
Well, my daughter, she's 9. She was bit by a copperhead last weekend.
Oh, no. That's a bad, like very poisonous snake.
Yes, it was horrible, but she's going to be just fine. But I got my bill today, and the one dose of anti-venom cost $103,000.
No!
No way!
Wow! Yeah. I know that it is like hard to collect and it's very expensive, and I get that. That is just a crime.
Did you pay it?
Well, no, my insurance covered everything. Thank God. Thank God. And she's going to be just fine. But when I saw that, everything on the bill was $90 here, $100, and then $103,000.
You had to be thinking that's a mistake. Like, you're like, that can't be right.
Yeah.
Crystal, had it been your dog or your cat, would you have still done it?
Or your husband.
Or your husband.
He's fine. Walk it off. Walk it off. I'm not paying $100K for that.
Monday School is what Wally learned at church in 3 minutes or less. Think of it as like the Twitter version of church.
So much of our faith is focused on how we as believers treat non-believers. And Romans 14, though, talks about how we should treat each other inside of the faith. I think it's a good reminder that, like, there are plenty of differences in church, which isn't bad. I mean, we have so many denominations, but we can learn to navigate that stuff more constructively than I think we do. We get a little judgy in the church as well. And one thing to keep in mind is to not get caught arguing over the non-essential elements of faith. Like, for example, movies, music, dancing, drinking, eating, types of baptism. Like, everybody's got their opinions about that stuff. Mm-hmm. But they're not faith. They're not, like, salvation-driven. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And so the point of this was they had discourse even in Jesus' day, and we have it today. However, we should be in agreement over the things that are indisputable in faith.
Right.
You know, and like Jesus being the Son of God, that's the thing we should not waver on for sure. The other stuff, you know, you could negotiate that with people, you know. Romans 14 says, accept the one whose faith is weak without quarreling or disputable matters. One person's faith allows him to eat anything, but another whose faith is weak eats only vegetables. Ha ha! Called vegetarians weak. Okay. That's all I got from this. There's your Monday School. But the one who eats everything must not treat with contempt the one who does not. And the one who does not eat everything must not judge the one who does. Mm. For God has accepted them collectively. Mm. So all the things we argue about.
Yes.
And we elevate. God's like, look, I cover all of you.
Well, and I heard from one pastor. He was like, you know, there might be a conviction that you have that another doesn't have. And that doesn't mean you should judge that person's faith walk. That it's, and that's true. Like, no, we shouldn't put ourselves in the seat of a judge. Instead, that belongs to God.
Because here's the tough part in this, though. It says, if your brother or sister is distressed because of what you eat, you are no longer acting in love. Do not, by your eating, destroy someone who Christ died for. Hmm. So basically, it's saying, does the Bible allow you to have a drink as long as you're not getting drunk? Yes. But if doing so causes someone in your life to stumble, then you should not do it. Mm-hmm. Do you have the right to do it? Fine. Do you have the right to go see movies? Do you have the right to do all this other? Yeah, it allows for these things. But it also says, if it's messing with somebody, don't do it with them or in front of them or make an issue of it with them, because you're causing them to stumble, and that is worse. You know, so basically, how do we live at peace? We don't let disputable issues become primary and non-disputable issues like salvation become secondary. And I think if we do this, it's not only going to help our church be stronger, but it might actually go outside the walls of the church and actually help kind of heal a broken and wounded world.
It's easy to let the fear of the unknown keep us from doing something that is good for us, but going back to school might not be quite what you think.
Yeah, one of my biggest fears going back to school was I'd have to watch a ton of online lectures, and I kind of have a problem staying awake during stuff like that, but it was so different than I had imagined, and way better.
Yeah, for sure. I thought I was going to have to take a bunch of tests, which I am not a fan of, but instead I was able to write papers, which for me was way better.
Plus, you have the flexibility to work in school around your work and life schedule. Another big fear I had is, what if I don't understand something? What do I do?
Yeah, CCU, they foster community with your classmates, and they are a great resource. And Colorado Christian University has very responsive online professors who are there to help you, so you are never alone as an online student at CCU.
Learn more about how you can pursue your passion and find your calling with Colorado Christian University at ccu.edu. Colorado Christian University is a nonprofit impact partner committed to cultivating the mind without compromising the heart.
Uplifting Way FM.
If you're not careful, you might just learn something today.
Hi there. Is there a project you're working on?
I know more than you.
All right.
It's The Wally Show.
So if we're being honest, most of us as parents have used TV, iPads, phones, technology to distract our kids and give us a minute.
Give me a minute.
I know, I'm telling you, man. Unfortunately, though, studies are showing that that may not be the best pattern to set for your kids long term. The amount of screen time that people or young kids spend instead of doing physical activities like sports, hiking, whatever, could be linked to health issues in their adulthood. Is what they're saying.
I believe that. Yeah. I mean, our doctors have always been saying you need to eat healthy, you need to exercise at least 30 minutes a day.
Well, they say that kids and like teenagers who spend more time watching television and less time, you know, exercising and doing that thing have higher blood pressure, higher rates of obesity into mid and adulthood, which it tends to make sense. The correlation isn't rocket science. Kids who have more screen time do less physical activity because of the sedentary activity of sitting down. They're going to put on weight, and then they're going to have probably poor eating habits because you're just grabbing fast food and things you can eat while you're sitting there.
Yeah, like it's okay to, I think, for kids to enjoy those kind of things, but in limits.
Yeah.
Like there needs to be boundaries.
And that was part of the thing of this, you know, study, if it helps you out. Like screen time is inevitable. You don't have to completely keep your kids off of it, but it's like life. Balance is important, you know, and look, I parked my kid in front of Disney sing-along videos back in the day when I needed a few minutes to myself, so I get it.
But setting these boundaries for kids is also important as an adult, you know, then we don't have parents that are looking out for us. Kids do, so hopefully what they learn in their childhood can go into their adulthood.
Yeah, you probably need to do the same thing, like set screen limits for everyone.
Oh, for sure.
Because then you seem less hypocritical.
Yes.
Like if you're always on your phone, then your kids are going to be like, hey, well, why can you always do it? And you say, because I'm the parent. I said so. That doesn't work either. So yeah, I think it's just a good reminder in this. And it's funny too, because this study goes all the way back to 1973 and they followed kids till they were 45. So it's a long-term study that they were doing. I could not be a scientist because I would have lost interest and stopped.
Yeah.
Like I would have stopped keeping up with these kids at some point in time. This is why we have science people, and science people help us out with this stuff. So maybe if you're like wrestling through this with your kids, setting the expectations too, and let them decide, have them be part of the conversation. Like, okay, what do you think is fair?
Yeah.
And then when they say I should be able to be on the phone 1,000 hours a week, you go, hey, that's a little much, and you dial it back. But then that way there's a clear expectation.
Well, and a compromise.
Exactly, and you work through it together. And I think that's a healthy way to teach them how to address things beyond the screen time in the future as well. Uplifting Way FM. This is The Wally Show. And companies spend millions of dollars on research to understand their customers or better understand them, what motivates them, what makes them make a purchase. And so how is this applicable to sharing your faith, you might ask?
That's what I'm asking. How is this applicable to sharing our faith?
Thank you. Because I came across this thing that talks about what people of faith need to know about people who do not have faith want from conversations with Christians. It's always good to understand, you know, the people that you're speaking to know what motivates them or know what makes them tick, because then you can better communicate.
Well, and I think too, I know that this is true for me. I overcomplicate everything, and I know I'm not alone in that. And I think we can overcomplicate our faith and sharing our faith. So sometimes when it gets down to the simplicity of it, it is helpful.
Yeah, and it is really simple. The top thing they found that people look for in a conversation with a Christian, if they're a non-believer, is to listen without judgment. Like, that's it. I mean, like, how
simple.
How easy is that, really, to have? But we feel like we've got to lay everything out, and then we've got to, it's almost like if you're, I see a lot of people do this, like, when they're sharing their faith, is they focus on the things you're not supposed to do. You know, like, oh yeah, Jesus is great, but you can't do this, can't do this, can't do this, can't do this. And if you don't do all those things, then you've got salvation. And that's just not the way it is. And it also puts somebody on the defense. Well, what if I do three of those things you just mentioned? Well, you can't. Okay, why? Well, because, you know, and then it leads to this whole
other
thing.
Well, and two, we can tend to come across as like, we're perfect. We've got it all,
right,
you know, put together. And then that doesn't help people feel like they have a connection with us because we have nothing in common.
This thing said, people of no faith are also hoping for honesty about questions and doubts. Because that's, I mean, that's good. Because, look, there are things I don't understand about my own faith still, you know, that I'm still learning and things like that. And you have to remember that people don't just know things all of a sudden, and they're going to have questions and tough questions sometimes, and they don't want to, like, forced conclusions either is the other part of this.
forced conclusions.
It's tough. This is the tough line to walk about absolutes. You know, when you're like, Jesus is the Son of God, and that's it, the only way to heaven. I believe that. Mm-hmm. But then, like, sometimes in saying it directly like that, it can force some, it can shut somebody down.
Yeah.
And so that's a tougher nuance,
yeah.
You know, inside of this, you know, to mm-hmm. how do you speak truth and not water it down? Because you cannot do that, but in a way that doesn't come across as judgmental or whatever.
Right.
So
it comes across as more relatable.
Right. And so it comes down to listening without judging and less about talking and more about listening to them. And then that can better help you know what to tell them, mm-hmm. kind of thing. If you're so focused on, I've got to share this, I've got to share all these bullet points, mm-hmm. versus listening and then going, okay, this is what's applicable to this person in this moment. So I am curious about this with you. So that's kind of like what this thing found. But what was the conversation that you had with someone that led you to following Christ? Was it something that was a person just listening to you and not judging you? Was it somebody's kindness and empathy and realizing that it wasn't about a notch on a Christian belt? It was about concern for you as a person and your eternity. You know, I'm just curious, like, how that played out for you. So 855-33-WAY-FM is the number. That's 855-33-WAY-FM. We'd just love to hear your experience because it might help somebody else in sharing their faith as well today. 855-33-WAY-FM. We're just curious, like, your conversation with somebody that ended up leading you to Christ, what was that like?
Back then, I'm talking about almost 35 years ago, I was a drug addict. I used to do drugs, right? And then I met my friend at the bus stop, but she always talk about God differently. She never judged me. She knew I was, you know, doing all this kind of stuff. One day she invited me to church. What brought me to Christ was the love she has for Christ, and she never judged me for what I was doing. And that day when I went to church, I heard this love. And that's it. They got me. I'm hooked almost 40 years later.
That's great. So you've been clean that long. That's amazing.
Oh,
good
my
for you.
God, yes.
I think what's interesting is it was a two-pronged approach. It was one, she didn't judge you, and two, you could see the joy of her faith. Too many of us, we have faith, but where's the joy, mm-hmm. you know? And I'm guilty of that as well. And so that joy, when Christ is truly living in you and truly living through you, is contagious, and that's what you found. Yes. And I really appreciate you, Martha, being on the show with us today. Thank you.
You're welcome. Thanks so much. I love your show. God bless you. And listen, Jesus is the way, but it's not a religion, it's a relationship with your Heavenly Father through Him.
See, Martha's got that joy I was just talking about.
I do.
Uplifting Way FM, this is The Wally Show, and we're talking about the thing that people that don't have faith look for in faith conversations with believers, and the number one thing was listen without judgment. There's this really cool story from country star Walker Hayes, whose life was just kind of in a downward spiral, and he met this guy named Craig, and Craig didn't judge him, but instead cared for him and tangibly showed him the love of Christ. And here, check out this story. I think it's pretty cool.
So, you know, Craig had walked, you know, beside us through this dismal, you know, music career, wasn't going anywhere. I was working at Costco up the street at 4 a.m. I was an alcoholic. I drank sun up to sun down for about a year solid, you know, and there was a point where we would be riding home from Craig's house with my wife, and I would literally ask her, why do you think these people love us so much? I mean, I could not make him go away. But one thing that kind of infuriated me was that he was a Christian. And that was not how I saw Christian. I had lower expectations for believers based on my past. And then, you know, he gave us the vehicle. Like the song says, he did show up in my son's baseball game with the title and the keys in his hand. We had one car. We were driving everywhere illegally. Like every light we'd pull up, my kids would duck down, you know, so a cop didn't see us all. We didn't have enough seatbelts. And
oh,
so
wow.
He provided us with this car, and it embarrassed me. It was the bravest thing I think I've ever witnessed someone do. I did not want to accept the vehicle. You would have thought I'd have been glad, you know, but
no, I
felt like ashamed. You know, I was like, I've sunk this low. But Craig said something that night. He said, man, somebody did this for me once. Just let me do this for you. And that gave me permission to be weak. And then I could never really thank him face to face in a way that I thought was meaningful enough. And so I began to write this song. And I just want to say I love you. Thank you for the gift of your kindness. Whatever you got, I don't know what it is, but you like the song says, you might actually know some dude named Jesus.
Yeah, it's a great song. Here's a little bit of it. If you've never heard it, it's called Craig.
Yeah, I know. It sounds cool, right? Not your typical kid from Sunday school, right? I still ain't figured out church yet. But Craig, I get. So now he can't walk on water or turn a nap of valley red. But he just might be tight with a man that did. Now he ain't the light of the world, but I wish mine was bright as his. Yeah, he just might be tight.
Even has Mercy Me on it, too, which is pretty great. Bart from them. If you want to check out the whole interview, I think it's really, really, like, cool, and it's a great story. You can just text the word Walker, W-A-L-K-E-R, to 91979, and we will gladly send you a link.
And now for some good news.
Uplifting! Way FM, this here's The Wally Show with a little good news. Giddy up. Three rapid-fire good news stories coming at you because the regular news can be a bit of a bummer. Let's start with you, Betty Rock. Good news. Giddy up. Go.
So we're not clear where this happened, but there was a kid that knocked on this random guy's door. And I say guy. We don't even know who was inside. We just know that this kid, he saw a bunch of kids in his neighborhoods doing like the ding-dong ditch.
Oh, yeah.
And so they ring the doorbell, then run off. And so this older kid felt bad for this person that just got ding-dong ditched. And so he rang their doorbell, and he gave them a little pep talk.
There's always going to be somebody that cares about you. And you're a good person. No matter what people say, you matter.
Now, as far as ding-dong ditch standards go, that's the worst ding-dong ditch ever. As far as, like, what a good kid.
Right.
Like, it's awesome. Sweet. I love that. Nicely done. Gavin, good news, giddy up, go.
There was a surfer in Australia that found an old Rolex watch at the bottom of the ocean, and he actually ended up getting it back to its rightful...
No.
What? Sell it? This is good news, giddy up. Got it back to its rightful owner. Turned out it was another surfer had lost it back in 2019. So this thing has been down there for a long time. And kind of a cool ending. It still worked, actually.
Yeah. What? And they're like 10 grand for those watches.
Sell it.
Yeah. I don't know how you even track that person down. I'd
no
be like,
idea.
Oh, cool. I found something. But good on him. And then finally, for the last decade, there's been a bunch of stray cats living at Coors Field in Denver.
Aww.
And they keep, they make their keep by catching mice. Well, their oldest one is retiring him.
No.
His name is Smokey, Lady Rock.
Smokey.
Yeah. And an animal rescue group is finding him a forever home or a forever home.
Precious.
Hey.
I can't.
They put out a statement saying he's retiring from his unofficial post as head of pest control. And they've already had a bunch of people with applications to adopt.
That is so cute.
Yeah, so there you go. That's your good news. Giddy up for the day.
Uplifting Way FM.
He's wise beyond his years.
I can't really tell, but it seems like he's very good.
Here's Gavin.
With incredibly hot temperatures surging throughout not just the United States, but the world, people are searching for strategies to combat heat while still enjoying some of the things that we love about summer, like pool parties and going to the beach and hanging out outside. And skin protection is always one of those things that people, and especially parents, are really considerate of over the summer. I went to a pool party like 3 weeks ago, and
yeah.
I was like, oh, hey, honey, I'm going to risk it. I'm not going to put sunscreen on for just a little bit.
And you're a redheaded kid.
And pale as can all be,
yeah.
That was the worst decision of my entire life.
I grew up working in construction in the sun in Florida, and I never thought twice about it. My dad didn't think twice about it, never. And then he had a bunch of like skin cancer when he got older. And so I'm more cognizant of it now. Like if I'm out at the lake or something, I will put spray sunblock
spray?
On. No,
oh,
no.
Okay.
Oil. I want to get deep and dark.
Yes, there we
I want to look like that George Hamilton guy. I'm more mindful of it, but I don't like freak out about it.
No, and you have usual things like sunscreen, maybe wearing a hat,
yeah.
But there's this interesting trend that's taking off in China where a lot of people tend to be fairer skinned out there. It's basically a ski mask where you have holes for eyes, nose, and mouth, but the name that they went with, they call it a Facekini.
That's weird.
It's not something that I want to adopt here over here, but it's just this thing that they use because they say that they're cognizant of, you know, future skin diseases or sunspots. But it's there. It's hard for me, though, because that's a temperature, that's a skin protection thing. But if it's 100 degrees outside,
right,
it's going to make right. It looks like one of those ball wool face things that you do, like if you're going to do a bank robbery.
Yeah, ski mask.
There
yeah,
you go.
It looks like that, but it's thinner. It's like a thinner material. But honestly, like, I know that you don't want skin cancer.
No.
But you also don't want people to think you're crazy.
Yeah, that's a tough line. I think we're on a good track here that we're on with, like, sunblock.
Yeah.
SPF a billion, that's fine.
Yeah.
But, yeah, although I could see my wife going, oh, this makes sense.
I need a face key.
Yeah. It's like
that. She asked you to wear one?
Yeah. Oh, no, that's not happening. I'm sticking with my mankini. Enjoy that.
Ew.
Uplifting Way FM, this is The Wally Show, and we have a chance for you right now to find out if you are normal or not. This is a service we offer, okay? It's called Am I Weird Because? And we'll share with you a story of something that we do that might be weird and find out if it's odd or not. And then we'll do the same for you. We'll help you by going around the room to let you know if something you do is like, oh yeah, I do that too, or that's a little odd.
Mm-hmm.
So Gavin, I noticed the other day Gavin got a credit card, a new credit card, so he had to get rid of your old credit card, which you did what?
I did this is one that I've been taught ever since the dawn of time, is that when you switch out credit cards, you
yes.
cut up the credit card, the debit card.
And not into four pieces,
no.
into hundreds of pieces.
You slice that thing
yeah.
to oblivion.
Yeah.
And then I was taught, like, you want to throw that away.
Yeah.
But I was also told that I need to throw those pieces away in different trash cans,
yes.
in different locations.
Yes.
And so some
what?
Of said pieces
yep.
were thrown out here at work. And by here at work, I mean like five different trash cans
okay,
here at work.
That might be a little much, because that way no one could get the card and piece it back together again
and
I
use took
the number.
The other half back home.
Attaboy.
And threw it away back at home.
Good idea.
Okay, I think it's safe to say in this room that
yes.
I'm the one that watches the most crime
yes.
on
yes.
TV or listen on
and out and out your window.
yeah,
lives in a rough
too.
Neighborhood.
So you would think that this is something I would do, but I'm kind of surprised to hear that you would do it. And I think it is odd.
Do you really? You think it's
yeah,
weird?
Yeah. Okay. Like, do you think people are really digging through the trash to figure that out?
They could.
I mean, I've been hacked before.
Yeah.
And I have no idea how they did that.
I will say this, Gavin. You went above and beyond. I will cut my credit card. I cut it right through the numbers, and then
yep.
I cut it diagonally so the numbers are, like, irrecognizable. And then I will take a handful and throw it away in my kitchen garbage, and then I will take a handful and throw it away in another trash can.
Grief.
That's
I
what
lit
I was
mine
taught
on
as
fire.
Well.
Oh, no.
Oh,
great
gosh.
Idea. That's there you go.
I didn't go far enough.
You did not, actually. You pulled up short. Now I'm disappointed. All right. So I don't think you're weird at all. We're 50-50 on this one, me and Betty. So what is yours? What is that thing that you maybe have been told makes you weird, or you're just... You got a hankering, you know, a thought that maybe this makes you weird. We will help you right now determine that once and for all. Am I weird? Because 855-33-WAY-FM. That's 855-33-WAY-FM. We'll take yours right now. What do you got?
Okay, so I can promise you that nobody probably does this, because everybody I tell it are like, you're crazy, and it's not just because you're 40. I do not eat or drink anything blue.
Oh, okay, why? What's the significance of that?
I have no idea. No blue M&Ms, no blue Skittles, no blue Sour Straws, no blue drink. If it's blue and you give it to me, I'm throwing it away. I have no idea why, and I've been that way since I was like 16.
Did you have a possible run-in or some traumatic experience with Smurfs when you were a kid?
Probably so. When I get my Skittles or M&Ms, I will literally lay them out and separate them, and the blue ones either go to somebody else or they go in the trash.
What amount of money would it take for you to eat a blue M&M?
I mean, if anybody wants to pay me $1 million, I'll eat some, but we gotta get
I would lower my standards a smidge
wow.
on that. I think you could make $10 at a party.
Yeah, but you're right.
Well, Emily, normally I like to side with the person with the story, but in this case, I'm gonna have to go with your friends. This
yeah,
one's weird.
Really weird.
I thought y'all might. You know, as much as I love y'all and been listening to you, I don't blame you one bit. I'll still keep y'all on my radio.
There you go. Well, Emily, thanks for being on with us. You're the best, girl. Have a great day.
Sure. Thank you. Y'all have a blessed day, too. Bye.
All right. That's Emily's What Is Yours? That thing that you think might make you weird. We'll help you figure that out. 855-33-WAY-FM. That's 855-33-WAY-FM for Am I Weird Because? What is yours?
Well, it doesn't matter where I am. When I take the stairs, I have to count them. And then I memorize the places where I've been. I know in my own house, and I count the stairs every time, there's 16 steps.
Oh,
when I go
wow.
see my son at his apartment, there's 20 steps. When I take the steps at the parking garage, there's 14 steps. Like, I just memorize them and count everywhere I go.
Okay, so that sounds like an OCD-ish kind of thing. Do you see this? I mean, do you think, maybe?
I do, but it's the only thing I count.
Okay, so that's the only thing you do. I thought you might see this in other areas of your life. Okay, well, then
no,
that's
it's
less
just
weird.
Stairs.
Yeah, or does that make it more weird that this is the one thing she does? I'm on the fence.
Well, and what if you found yourself, like, going up to the Eiffel Tower or the Statue of Liberty? Like, I've done that before, and you have to take the stairs. I think you would lose count.
I mean, I've never lost count. I guess I've never been, you know, a flight of stairs that was so high that I lost count.
Wow, that's she's just super committed to this. Well, Melanie, that's pretty impressive. I've never heard somebody that just does, like, one thing like this. Usually it's a manifestation of other things. I'm going to say, I'm weird. I'm going to say weird. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you for confirming that. Yeah. I feel much better. I can go on and have a great day now.
Well, thank you, Melody. Have a great day.
You too. Bye-bye.
Bye. Uplifting Way FM, this is The Wally Show, and we got a really cool chance for you, an opportunity, if you will, to live out your faith in a tangible way, because I know we talk about things politically and things that we don't like, and, you know, we have issues with all these different things going on in the world, but it's like, how can we live out our faith in a way that shows what we love maybe more than what we don't like, you know? And so that's why we came up with our world's biggest baby shower. This is where you're meeting women at a very difficult time for themselves. They've found themselves pregnant, not planning on it, and it's like, what do I do now? Sure, you could throw a heaping helping of judgment. That'd be a bad strategy. Or you could show them the love of Christ by giving them the things that they need to walk through this and loving them well. And that's what we've chosen to do with our world's biggest baby shower.
So when you text BABY to 91979, so texting the word BABY to 91979, we'll send you a link of the things that are needed. So if, like Wally was saying, if you'd like to live out your faith, we're looking for diapers, wipes, cans of formula, and even gift cards. And there's a link when you text BABY to 91979. There's a link also to an Amazon wish list.
Yeah,
we've
made it easy as possible on you because we know you're busy, but here's a great way that you could do something nice and, you know, and help out somebody and not be too intrusive into your day either and stuff. Last year, we raised $30,000 in gift cards. Like, how crazy is that? People were beyond generous, and I love it because I love that we get to tangibly show who Jesus is through our actions versus just telling somebody or shouting at somebody, you know, and stuff like that. So this is a chance for you to be part of the solution, not just part of the discussion. We'd love to have you be part of it. Just text the word BABY to 91979. It's our world's biggest baby shower.
Growing up in poverty has never been easy for children, but with the added challenges of the pandemic, conflict, and natural disasters, families around the world are facing an unprecedented food crisis. Unfortunately, those who are already hungry are now even more desperate. But by sponsoring a child through Compassion, you can help provide life-sustaining essentials such as food and clean water. And with your compassionate support, that child can not only survive, but also flourish. You can find out how and choose a child to sponsor when you click on the Compassion banner at wayfm.com.
Attention, please.
Uplifting Way FM. Celebrities are just like you and me. Except, of course, for the mansions, tigers, and sequins. It's The Rock Report with Betty Rock.
Ariana Grande got her start on Disney in shows like Sam and Cat and Victorious.
Yeah, yes.
But she's now moved on to become a pop star sensation with hits like this one.
Yeah, for that I say thank you.
I would not have picked her to be the one that came out of Victorious as the star.
No, not at all. But now the 30-year-old has a new man in her life. His name is Ethan Slater. The 31-year-old actor played SpongeBob on Broadway.
Could be the best day ever.
Okay, he can sing, definitely. SpongeBob is hands down the worst musical I have ever seen in my life. And I've seen a lot.
I don't know why they decided that that was a good idea to make into a Broadway play.
Not necessary at all. And it's interesting that he meets Ariana Grande and she's like, what do you do for a living? And he's like, oh, I'm a bike messenger or something. Like, I would lie at that point.
Yeah, because you don't want to be known as SpongeBob on Broadway.
No.
Well, when the public heard the news of the new couple, they got confused thinking Ariana was dating the guy that did the voice of SpongeBob in the cartoons.
I'm ready. Yeah, that guy's stock just went up.
Yeah, that guy is 61-year-old voice actor Tom Kenny. Yeah,
he's 61?
61 years old. And when word got to Kenny's wife, she made sure to set things right.
Oh, okay.
So stating that her husband wasn't seeing Ariana, that we had our facts wrong, but that she wished Ariana and Ethan all the best in their new relationship.
Her husband's like, couldn't you just let it have gone like a day? Like, just please. I'm 61. Let people think that Ariana Grande is into me. Please. That's awesome. Well, congratulations to the happy couple.
Yeah.
I hope they get married under the sea.
It could be the best day ever.
The best day ever.
Oh, that's funny. All right, that's going to do it for your Rock Report. Thank you, Lady Rock. Uplifting, Way FM, this is The Wally Show. When we find things that we're not even 100% sure if we agree on it or not, we like to get your take on it with five calls. Calls it. So a lady gets on a plane. She goes to sit in her seat, and there's another lady already sitting in her seat with her kids. And the lady just assumed she would switch with her because she has kids. And she's like, well, you wouldn't want to sit with my kids, so we could just switch seats. Well, the lady booked a window seat, and the lady that was sitting there with her kids had a middle seat behind her. She's like, mine's just one row back, but it was a middle seat. Mm. And the lady that booked the seat wanted it because she doesn't like to fly. She gets motion sick, likes to see out.
No one wants to sit in the middle seat.
No, absolutely not. So there's a couple things at play here, okay? You could say she should have planned better, you know, should have bought her tickets earlier, you know, to be with her kids. Mm-hmm. And I know, but then people will defend that. Well, maybe she didn't have the money or maybe she didn't do that. Okay, fine. Her kids are also 11 and 15. They're not little kids. Like, if they were little kids, I could see it more so, okay?
Yeah.
And then the other part is flight attendants are pretty good at that, like helping move people, and mm-hmm. if you ask, you know, mm-hmm. let them do the dirty work for you. But just sitting in that seat and making the assumption, and you're already parked there, I think is a problem.
The assumption is the part that bothers me. Because if I were in that situation, I would like to think that I'd be like, no, I paid for the window seat. That's what I'm getting.
Yeah.
You can move back a row.
You'd like to think that's what you would do?
Yes.
I thought you were going to say, I'd like to think I would be kind and move.
No.
Oh, my goodness. What is
I
wrong
think
with
I
you?
Would have been, I think, here's the thing. I want to think that I would push back and I would say, no, that's the seat I paid for. That's what I'm getting. But I think in reality, I would just go to the
middle
seat.
I love that you want to be the jerk.
Yes. But not jerk. I don't know. I mean, you paid for that seat.
I would move.
You would take the middle seat.
I've taken worse seats on a flight so that families could be together and things like that. Now, I do have a little bit of a caveat. If it's like a 9-hour flight, that's a lot different than like 3, 4, 5-hour flights.
But they're 11 and 15.
I know. That is another factor,
come
too.
On.
So I'm not sure. I'm just curious. Betty Rock, though, that was telling. I'd like to think, and I thought it was going to be the good thing, but it was like, I'd like to think I would say no. All right. So where do you land? Would you switch it up or stay put? I'm just curious where you land on this. 855-33-WAY-FM. We'll do a little five calls it. You help us figure this stuff out. 855-33-WAY-FM. Would you switch it up or would you stay put, Caleb?
I would probably stay put. I'm thinking of it as that because of the kid's age. If they're under the age of 10, they can stay. If they're above it, the mom can go.
Okay. Yeah, the kids were 11 and 15, so it's not like toddlers.
Right, because if it was, like you were saying, Caleb, if they were like 1 and 5, you don't want to sit next to them. That makes sense. But they're 11 and 15.
Right. All right, Carol, you're up. Would you switch it up or stay put?
So my mom is with Betty Rock. She says she would not be shamed into changing her seat because that's the seat that she paid for, and the lady probably should have planned it a little better.
Yeah.
I'm actually really dependent on how nicely I'm asked. If she's really apologetic about it, you know, I just really want to be near my kids, mm-hmm. and I probably would just move.
Where she just took the seat and sat down and camped out and then was like, oh, I figured you wouldn't want to sit here. That is a problem to me, the entitlement part of it. Mm-hmm. You know,
yeah.
And so I'm like you. If someone wants to ask really nicely, then 100% I'm going to move easily.
Yeah.
You know, here's the thing I feel like I have to bring up. Betty Rock earlier said, I would hope that I would be the person, and I was waiting for her to go, that would change seats with her. But she literally goes, I would hope I would be the person that would say, no, I'm keeping my seat. Mm-hmm. That tells me, that statement right there sheds light on how conflict averse you are.
Oh, yeah. I swallow a lot of feelings.
Yeah. So, like, your thing is, I'm going to get walked on. And so you must get walked on a lot in life because you're like, I hope I would be the person that would stand my ground.
Yeah. Yeah. I want to be that person because you do it so well. I want to be that person, but I just don't have it in me.
Betty's like, I want to be that person that is taken off a plane in handcuffs.
Yes. Yes.
Uplifting Way FM. This is the Wally Show. Do a little scoop now. This is where we give you some information that might help make your life a little bit better. And we got the scoopiest of the scoopers, Betty Rock.
Thank you for that introduction. I found this scoop on TikTok. So this woman claims that she learned this from her grandmother, but it's how to get the stains out of an old Tupperware.
Okay. Now this is very important because my wife loves her Tupperware like more than I'm thinking me and the cat. But, like, she will caution me about what I put in it because it will stain it, and she doesn't like
anything tomato-based, you can't get it out. So here, and it's so easy. That's the thing. So you need to find yourself that stained Tupperware that you want to keep.
Yeah.
Okay, you're going to put in it, like, an inch of warm water.
Okay.
Then you're going to put in a dab of dishwashing liquid soap. Okay.
Please tell me that's not it.
No, it's not.
Okay, because that's like washing it.
Let me finish.
Okay, sorry.
So then you take a paper towel and you rip it up into little pieces.
Okay.
And you throw that in.
Okay.
Then you're going to put the lid on real tight and you're going to shake that Tupperware. Shake it, shake it, shake it, shake it, shake it. And that stain is going to absorb into the paper towel.
Wait, what?
And it gets the stain out.
There's no way.
I don't know.
There's no way. That's the
same
as
TikTok.
That's the same as taking a sponge and just wiping it out.
She did a video and it worked amazingly.
Really?
Yes. You try it and then you accuse me of falsehood.
I think that they're like, because we have one that is my Fisherman's Wharf jambalaya stained it.
Might be the problem.
Yeah, I don't even want to know what it's done on my inside. But it's a dish I make that turned it like orange.
Yeah.
And so I'm curious if it's ever too late. Like, will it work now?
Well, that I don't know.
Yeah.
But try your jambalaya,
Fisherman's Wharf jambalaya.
Yeah. Get that Tupperware. And try my scoop, and you tell me whether it works or not.
When you do scoops, a lot of times I'm like, well, she's just crazy, and that's it. And then inevitably, someone will email me the next day. It's like, you know what? I heard Betty Rock scoop, and I scooped it up, and I did it, and it worked, by golly, and it does.
And you're welcome.
Exactly. So try it and let us know if it works, actually. I doubt this one, but that's your scoop for today. Uplifting Way FM. This is the Wally Show. And when you ask like your friends to pray for something, there's only so many people that are there in your life that you can have pray for you. And that's why if that's a big important thing to you, the prayer wall at wayfm.com is so cool because you can have a bunch of people. You post a prayer request, something that's on your heart, on your mind, and you can have a bunch of people that are praying for you. And then there's another cool feature where when they pray for you, they can click a box if they choose to that just lets you know, hey, somebody just prayed for you. Somebody just prayed for you. You get notifications. And that's the cool part of the prayer wall. I think it just makes you feel like, you know what? Other people are kind of in this with me.
Yeah, and these are the type of requests you'll see on the prayer wall. This one is from Jay. She said, I'm a broken wife here who is desperate to see hope and healing for my husband's stability, mental health, and a long-term job. Also, I deeply am yearning for the right man of God to drop into my husband's life to love on him, encourage him, and mentor him.
Oh, wow. Yeah, I mean, because women, they want their husbands to be the spiritual leader of the home. We're supposed to be, you know, and a lot of times we're not, you know, and I get it right sometimes. I get it wrong a lot of times. and so I get that, you know, where that's a desire for her. And I like the prayer, though, too. It's like that God would send somebody into his life to kind of bring him along. Because I had that happen for me.
Yeah. But when she's in the depths of that and wondering, like, Is God hearing me? She could get that notification on her phone or through her email, and it could be you saying you prayed for her, and she'll get that notification. It could be just the thing that she needs.
Yep, at the right time, too. And so, yeah, when you go on the prayer wall, like, just if you're going to post something, great, but if you go there anyway, just peruse it a little bit and see if there's something that just jumps out and connects with you and that you're uniquely qualified to pray for because it's similar to a situation you've walked through. And we'd love to have you be part of it. Just text the word pray to 91979 and we will send you a link.
Well, that's the end, but it doesn't have to be. Check out our Aftercast. It's new stuff you didn't hear in the podcast. Be sure to rate us on iTunes as well as connect with us on social media. Just search Wally Show. And if you'd like to join our Facebook group made exclusively for you potties, the link is in the description of this podcast. Thanks to Colorado Christian University Online for supporting what we do.